Welcome, everyone. It is Thursday morning at 7 a.m. I have to admit, this is earlier than I normally work out. You know, when all you have all day is to work out several times, you don't have to start very early, usually. But I wanted to make sure we got some people here who normally have to work. So thanks for getting up early and joining me. As I was just saying, this workout is 2 by 30 minutes. We're going to do it at rate 22. It's going to be LD. For those of you watching the video, you can check the description for the zones, but LD is basically a little harder than steady state and not quite anaerobic threshold. So I'm going to be keeping my heart rate under 155. There's going to be a 15-minute warm-up and cool-down. In the warm-up and cool-down, I'll make some technical calls. We'll work a little bit on technique, but during the pieces, we're just going to be focusing on working hard and breathing hard. All right, so start out. Make sure you set your drag factor. I like to set mine between 115 and 120. For me, that means the fan is on 5. All right, there we go. Going to take off a layer. If anybody has any questions, feel free to unmute yourself and ask away during the warm-up here, or really any time except for in the middle of the piece. All right. Start my heart rate monitor. Let's start out. By the way, I like to warm up feet out. I think it helps with technique, helps make sure you're keeping your core engaged. So I encourage you to do that. I've been doing it for 20 years, so I'm pretty good at it. So if you're not comfortable, then go ahead and put your feet in. Let's start out with arms only. We're going to do 5 minutes here of steady run. Arms only, ready, go. Didn't mean 5 minutes of arms only. I just realized that probably sounded crazy. We're going to build up to full and then do 5 minutes steady. Arms, body in 2, 1, 2. Just focusing on the sequence here. We're doing this pick drill at the start to make sure that we're getting the proper sequence of arms and then body. And then, of course, we're going to add in the legs soon. Let's go to quarter slide in 2, 1, 2, quarter slide. Half slide in 2, 1, 2. Three-quarter slide in 2, 1, 2. Three-quarter and full slide in two. One. Two. And just keep going nice and steady, 18 to 20, full slide. I'm going to take a second and adjust the angle of my camera. A little better. All right. Do a few more minutes here of just full slide steady rowing. And as we warm up, I like to check in a few technical focuses just at the beginning, make sure everything's working as it should. I start out with my neck and shoulders. Shoulders should be down and relaxed, back of the neck long. I even like to look down a little bit. It's okay to look down as long as you're not collapsing through your chest into the catch. It's actually good to keep the back of the neck nice and long. That helps prevent you from doing this. Next, I think about my core, making sure that's nice and engaged, both at catch and finish. Helps protect the back from injury. Then I think about my glutes. Make sure I'm engaging my butt muscles off the catch, getting my weight off the seat a little bit on the drive. Conversely, on the recovery, think about keeping my weight on the seat as I come into the catch. I want it on the seat as opposed to out over my toes. If my weight is too far forward, that means I'm lunging. And finally, I think about my feet. I want the pressure on the footboard to equal the pressure of my hands on the handle. If there's more pressure on the handle, that means that I'm opening too soon. And that would look like this. And if there's more pressure on the footboard, that would mean I'm shooting my slide, and that looks like this. So when they match, that means I'm suspending and staying strong through my core, like this. All right, coming up, we've got 2 minutes a little bit harder. 1 minute at 22, 1 minute at 24. Build to 22 and two. That's one. Build. This is the rate we're going to be at for the pieces today. So just getting a nice, relaxed rhythm going. And coming up, we've got a minute at 24. Build in 2, 1, 2, 24. And paddle. Woo! All right, getting warmed up. What I want to do now is a couple 20s, one leg only. This is one of my favorite drills. Thanks to Dave Ringham, Union Boat Club. We did this a lot. So take one foot out. Put it on the floor. Don't use it. So now you're just rowing with one leg. Now this just really helps you feel what I was talking about before, where you're engaging your glute and feeling the pressure on the footboard and the handle. Now that you only have one foot, it's a little bit amplified. I want to do a 20 at 20 into 1, 2. Now you're not going to be able to get splits quite as good, but you can actually get surprisingly close with just one leg. It just shows you how much power you have in your legs. You also have to keep your core nice and strong to prevent yourself from twisting from uneven press. Ten more on this leg. And paddle. And switch legs. Now I've got my left foot in. I guess it depends which one you started with. Take a few more on the paddle, and then we'll do a 20 on this leg. Into, that's 1. Build to 20. and paddle. And put both feet on now. We're going to do one more 20 at a 22. I want to have two different focuses here. For the first 10, I'm going to focus on pulling in just to my stomach, just above my belly button, below my bra strap or my heart rate monitor. I videoed myself the other day, and I realized I have a terrible habit of pulling in too high, which is very common. I pull in up here sometimes. So that's the first 10. The second 10 is going to be holding the knees. My other bad habit, I pop my knees too soon and I hit my handle. So I'm going to hold them down. All right, let's build to 22 and 2. That's 1, 2. First 10, just pulling in to the stomach. And now holding the knees. Paddle. And that's the warm-up. Feeling ready to go. Anybody have any questions? Comments? If you do, remember to take yourself off mute. And if not, then let's get ready to go.
Regarding the heart rate, what percentage do you think it should be at?
Let's see, if I'm 155, I want to say that's 70%. If my max is 185, quick math. It's more than 70. Okay, it's around 80% of your max. There are other ways to calculate it. You can do your heart rate reserve, which subtracts your resting heart rate. The best way to figure out your ranges is just to pay attention to your heart rate as you do various workouts and see how your heart rate correlates to perceived exertion. That's what I find. For me, when I get to 155, that's when I'm like, I cannot hold this for a lengthy period of time, and I can't talk while I'm doing it.
Good stuff.
My advice is to do the first piece a little bit conservatively. We always say, Coach Tom with the national team always says, you want to finish the workout stronger than you started. So aim to get faster throughout the workout, which usually means start a little bit slower than you think you need to. And then later you can really push it at the end. So if you don't know where to start, that's my advice. Start a little slower, see how it feels, and then build into the workout. Okay, so set your monitors. We're doing 30 minutes on, 5 minutes off. And for those of you whose monitors might be broken, as mine was for a time, you can just follow along. All right. Gonna strip that down another layer before we get going here. dropping in. Alrighty. Is everybody ready? I actually can't see anybody, so I hope you're ready, because we're starting. Sitting ready. We're building to 22. Attention. Go. First 10 minutes, just get a good rhythm. Nice and relaxed. All right, 5 minutes down. Quick check. Are your shoulders down? Your neck long? Your core engaged? Your glutes working? And your feet and hands pressing equally. Ten minutes down. goal for the next 10 minutes is just stay calm. Your heart rate's starting to get higher. Just breathe. way. Quick check. Pull in. Just your stomach. Wrist. Stay flat. Hold the knees. last 10 minutes. It's okay to let your heart rate go a little higher in this last 10. Bring it home. Last 5 minutes. keep your weight on the seat coming into the catch. No collapsing. Last minute, 22 strokes. And paddle. One down. One to go. Nice work, everybody. Gotta admit, my heart rate was a little higher than I expected on that one. But, felt okay. So I just went with it. The key is not to panic.
Same here, by the way.
Yeah. Usually that happens on Mondays for me. But it's Thursday. It's early.
May or may not have hit 180.
Wow. Who was that? Was that Eric? Hollenbeck?
Yeah, it was. Yeah. I was going a little harder than UT1, so my mistake.
Okay. Well, hey, you know, it all depends on your training goals. If you wanted to do a hard workout today, then that's what you should do. All right, we got 3.5 more minutes of rest. I like to recommend standing up just for, you know, 30 seconds or so, just to stretch out your back so that you're not in a sitting position for 90 minutes straight. Stand up, maybe stretch your hip flexors, get a drink. Well, I'm going to try to do that, the next piece, 0.1 faster than the last. I think that's all I got in me. It'll be faster, but not by much. Two and a half minutes left of rest. So as you probably figured out, what I like to think about during a 30-minute piece, the first 10 minutes, just establish your rhythm. That'll help keep your heart rate from climbing too high. Just no thinking, let the body do its thing. Second 10 minutes, so the middle 10 minutes, stay calm. Sometimes it's easy on a long piece to get ahead of ourselves and start thinking about the end too soon. So the middle 10, I like to just stay in the moment, be where I am. And then the last 10, that's where you can start thinking about the end. You can start driving it towards the line. Let your heart rate come up a little bit. At that point, it's just going. When we do 30-minute test pieces, I usually drop it by a split every 10 minutes. And it's interesting because when we do it as a test, it's rate capped at 22, and you can't have a single minute above a 22. We set it for a minute to record every minute. And on a PM5, it's possible to be at a 22 and a half and not know it and just see 22. And if you're at 22 and a half, every third minute in the memory will show up as a 23. So we actually have to row our tests closer to a 21 just to make sure we don't go over, because if you go over, you got to do it again. It doesn't count. And that's a miserable thing to happen. All right, 30 seconds more rest. Strap in. Start paddling. We're going to row into this one. So we'll start building in about 10 seconds. All right. Start building here to 22. Got about 5 seconds left. And we're on. breathe, get into a rhythm. Five minutes down, quick check, shoulders down, core engaged, glutes working, pressure foot forward, and handle. Middle 10 minutes, stay calm, stay present. halfway. Quick check. Pull into the stomach. Hold the knees. Thank you. last 10 minutes. Start to bring it home. I want you to look at your average split right now. If it's not faster than your last piece, figure out what you need to do to get it there and do it. If it is faster, keep up the good work. 5 minutes. Wait on the seat. No collapse. Last 2 minutes. Last minute, 22 strokes. Bring it home. And paddle.
Okay, that second one was harder.
Good. It's supposed to be.
Hey, Karen.
I
got to run, but thank you so much. I used the last 10 minutes of the workout for my cool down, but that was awesome. Thank you.
Sweet. Thanks for joining, Deb. Have a great day.
Hey, Karen.
Finish a piece. Make sure you're focusing on deep breathing. Actually, probably even more important in between pieces. Sometimes I can get that shallow breath and I have to really focus on long exhalations. How was it for everybody? I'm tired. We'll take another minute here.
It was exactly what I needed. Thanks.
Oh, good. That's great, Dex. We'll take another minute here to catch our breath, and then we'll do a cool down. I hear someone. Dave?
Yeah. Get yourself in here.
Finish it up.
See you later. I'm going to do a longer cool down, 15 minutes. You can stay the whole time or just do a couple minutes. Just make sure you get some kind of cool down. I always wondered, it took me 3 Olympics to figure out why I always felt awful after winning a medal. I, without fail, was falling asleep in my dinner plate at 10 p.m. feeling terrible, wondering why I couldn't feel more elation. And finally I realized it's because when you win a medal at the Olympics, you don't get to cool down. You go right into the medals dock, get your medal. You go to the press conference. You go to the press conference, and you never get to cool down. So that's why you feel terrible. Lesson learned, cool down. Very important. All right. So cool down, nice and easy. We're going to start with one arm rowing. So one arm rowing is good to really feel the extension in the lats. Your lats are your muscles underneath your shoulder. So as you're rowing, just really feel a nice stretch, keeping your shoulder down and kind of out of the socket as you come forward. The other thing this does is it gives you a nice ab workout as you twist. A bit like sweep rowing. And switch hands. I'd like to stick my middle finger in between the bolt of the erg handle. That makes it a little easier to row one arm. And two hands on, still nice and light here, feeling the stretch through both arms across the middle of your back. As you pull into the finish, squeeze the shoulder blades together. So first, extending them into the catch, squeezing them together into the finish.
Torin, I gotta jump, but thank you for hosting us today.
Yeah, thanks for joining, Tracy.
All right, see ya.
See ya. Take two more strokes and pause at the finish. That's one. Two. Pause here. Now I wanna do a little legs only. So come to bodies over, just like this. And now we'll do legs only, keeping your body just in this position. Ready. Row. The purpose of this drill is to make sure that you're using your legs off the catch without opening your body. I like to look down at my seat and make sure that my seat is moving at the same speed as my hands. We'll do two more legs only and row it out. That's one, two, full side rowing. Add in the body. I want to do some pauses now. We're going to do a pause at body over, and this is to make sure that we're not popping our knees too early. Pause in two, one, two. First arms, then body, and pause. Take two strokes. Go. And pause on this one. Pause. Go. Pause. Go. We'll do two more pauses. Pause here. Go. And pause. We'll go continuous. Go. And continuous, focusing on that sequence, arms, body, before the legs pop, before the knees pop up. All right, next 3 minutes, we're gonna do a couple 20s, just a little bit harder, just really to flush out. And after that, just gonna stretch for 5 minutes. So let's do a 20 at 20 in 2, 1. Two, build to 20 strokes a minute. Second 10. And paddle. Take a few strokes on the paddle here. 6 something.
Bye, I have to go, but thank you. It was fun. Thanks. Once again.
Thanks for joining. See you maybe next week.
Yeah, see ya.
All right, we got one more 20, and then we'll do some stretching. Build to 22 strokes a minute in 2. That's 1, 2. Paddle. All right. Got that lactate flushed out. Now, just a little bit of stretching, and we're good. I got 3 more warriors still on, doing the whole workout. Nice job, guys. Anybody have any questions, comments? Well, good. That means everybody followed along. No problem. I really recommend Five Parks Yoga for stretching. Erin Sampson, I think is her last name, does yoga videos anywhere from 10 minutes to an hour and 15. She does a great job leading you through stretches. I won't pretend that I can do any better. So if ever you need a good workout to limber you up, head on over to fiveparksyoga.com. But if you just want to stretch with me for a minute, that's great too. I like to make sure I get my hip flexors just like this and stretch out my back. Shoulders. Anybody have any good stretches? I'd love to hear it. So I plan on doing another one of these on Saturday, probably around 9:30. I'll post about it. The workout for Saturday is 6 by 8 minutes, step rate from 22 to 26. So that's what's on the agenda. But thank you for joining. I'm going to sign off now.
Karen, thank you so much.
You're welcome, Jack.
Yeah, thank you very much.
See you again.